A very good afternoon and welcome from the mission control at Satish Dhawan Space Center, Sriharikota, the spaceport of India. My name is Radhakrishnan, and with me my colleague Sri Alok will be bringing to you the live coverage of the GSLV-F08 GSAT-6A launch from the mission control center located at the spaceport of India. GSLV-F08 launch is a very significant one for the GSLV program and for Indian Space Research Organization, as it will pave the way for future launches of 2-ton class communication satellites from the Indian soil. Today's GSLV-F08 is the 12th flight of GSLV. The vehicle will use the indigenously developed cryogenic stage as its upper stage, and this will be the sixth time the indigenously developed cryogenic stage will be used for the GSLV flight. If you may recall, last year during May 2017, we had the successful flight of GSLV-F09, wherein GSAT-9 communication satellite, called a South Asia satellite, was very precisely placed in its intended geosynchronous transfer orbit, GTO. If you look at the countdown, we are at minus 29 minutes away from the launch. The countdown for the mission began yesterday around 1400 hours during daytime. The entire countdown process for this mission is a 27 hours process. As of now, the final countdown operations are progressing very smoothly. Launch vehicle has successfully completed all fuel loading operations. And vehicle is getting prepared for liftoff at 16:56 hours Indian Standard Time from the second launch pad. The second launch pad is located few kilometers away from the mission control center from where we are presently seated.
Dhanyavad Radhakrishnan ji, main Alok Srivastav. अपने वैज्ञानिक साथी राधा कृष्ण जी के साथ आप सभी दर्शकों का हार्दिक स्वागत करता हूं, अभिनंदन करता हूं। इस समय हम आंध्र प्रदेश के नेल्लूर जिले में स्थित श्री हरिकोटा में जो इसरो जहां पे इसरो का सतीश धवन अंतरिक्ष केंद्र है, वहां से आपको अभियान नियंत्रण केंद्र से आपको आंखों देखा हाल प्रस्तुत कर रहे हैं। आज GSLV-F08 द्वारा संचार उपग्रह GSAT-6A का प्रक्षेपण होने जा रहा है, जिसको हम दूसरे लॉन्च पैड से प्रक्षेपित करेंगे। ये GSLV की 12वीं और स्वदेशी क्रायोजेनिक इंजन युक्त भूस्थैतिक प्रक्षेपण यान की 6वीं उड़ान है, जिसमें एक उच्च शक्ति एस बैंड आधारित संचार उपग्रह GSAT-6A को भारतीय समय अनुसार आज अपराह्न 4:56 पर प्रक्षेपित किया जाना है। इस उपग्रह में 6 मीटर व्यास वाले अनफर्लेबल या प्रस्तरणीय एंटीना का प्रयोग किया जाएगा। इसका मुख्य उद्देश्य ग्राउंड टर्मिनल की मदद से उपग्रह आधारित मोबाइल संचार व्यवस्था की स्थापना करना है। इससे हम यान के अंतिम चरण के रूप में क्रायोजेनिक अपर स्टेज का उपयोग करने जा रहे हैं। 2117 किलोग्राम भारी GSAT-6 उपग्रह, जिसका शुष्क भार 985 किलोग्राम है, इसमें भारतीय जो स्टैंडर्ड बस है I-2 के, इस पे आधारित है। इस उपग्रह में सी बैंड तथा एस बैंड ट्रांसपॉन्डर लगाए गए हैं। एस बैंड प्रदाय भार मल्टीमीडिया सेवाएं प्रदान करेगा, जबकि सी बैंड प्रदाय भार देश की सामरिक आवश्यकताओं की पूर्ति करेंगे। कुल ऊर्जा उत्पादन क्षमता लगभग 3119 वाट है। इस उपग्रह को 170 × 35,975 किलोमीटर की दीर्घ वृत्तीय कक्षा, जो विषुवत रेखा से 20.63 डिग्री झुकी हुई होगी, में प्रक्षेपित किया जाना है, जिसे बाद में 3 कक्षीय उत्थान प्रक्रियाओं द्वारा कुल डेल्टा वी जो है 1656 मीटर प्रति सेकंड देकर 36,000 किलोमीटर की वृत्तीय कक्षा में 83 डिग्री पूर्व लॉन्जिट्यूडिनल या देशांश पर स्थापित कर दिया जाएगा, जहां पे पहले से ही जो भारत के उपग्रह हैं GSAT-6, GSAT-10 और GSAT-12 INSAT-4 जैसे उपग्रह ऑलरेडी वहां पे स्थापित हैं। इस समय हम लगभग 25 मिनट की दूरी पे,
सो वी आर एट माइनस 25 मिनट्स 34 सेकंड्स फॉर द लॉन्च। अ क्विक अपडेट ऑन द ओवरऑल मिशन। The 49-meter-tall GSLV F08 weighs 416 tons at launch, and GSLV F08 will place GSAT-6A communication satellite in geosynchronous transfer orbit with perigee altitude of 170 kilometers, which is the closest point from Earth, and at an apogee altitude of 36,000 kilometers, which is the farthest point from the Earth. The orbital inclination for this mission will be 20.6 degrees. And as I mentioned, the satellite on board this mission is GSAT-6A communication satellite, which is primarily meant for providing mobile communication services for India through multi-beam coverage. It has 5 spot beams in S-band and 1 beam in C-band. Another characteristic feature of this satellite is that it has 6-meter diameter unfurlable antenna for user communication link. And the spacecraft is built around I2K class bus, which is the 2000 kg class spacecraft. And if you look at the overall dimension of the spacecraft, it's around 2.4 meter CGC tall
control,
and 1.6 meter wide.
Of, umbilicals.
The final mission, once GSAT-6A is placed in geosynchronous transfer orbit by GSLV F08, the launch vehicle, the satellite will use its own propulsion system while performing 3 orbit-raising maneuvers to place itself in a 36,000 kilometer circular orbit where the orbital inclination will be zero, which means it will be an equatorial orbit, and the satellite will be located at 83 degree east longitude. As I was mentioning, the 27 hours countdown for the mission began yesterday, and some of the major operations during the countdown process involved propellant filling operation, which is the bulk of the activity that is generally performed during the countdown operations for the GSLV, as it has quite a number of liquid and cryogenic propellant that has to be loaded into the stages. Now, at the beginning of the countdown yesterday, the fuel and oxidizer were loaded into the second stage, which was the GS2 stage. And once this got completed, the fuel loading in all the 4 liquid strap-ons were performed, which was eventually followed with loading of oxidizer in all the 4 liquid strap-on motors. In fact, if you look at the total process, all this got completed today, very early morning. And just 4.5 hours from now, the filling of liquid oxygen in the cryogenic stage was initiated, and this activity lasted for nearly 2 hours. Generally, the cryogenic propellants get loaded into the launch vehicle very late in its phase, as it requires a lot of thermostating and other conditioning activity that has to be performed on these stages. And just 2 hours before, we had the loading of liquid hydrogen, which is the LH2, and it just got completed 1 hour before. And right now, both the cryogenic stages are going through the final phases of thermal conditioning activities. So if you look at the total number of amount of propellant that has been loaded into the vehicle, we have almost nearly 200 tons of earth storable liquid propellant and 12.8 tons of cryogenic propellant that has been successfully loaded into the GSLV F08 launch.
धन्यवाद. GSLV की बात हो रही है, तो GSLV से जुड़े हुए कुछ ऐसे इवेंट्स हैं जो आपको दर्शाने होंगे. उपग्रह एवं प्रक्षेपण यान के अलग अलग निर्माण के पश्चात उनका आपस में समाकलन एक जटिल प्रक्रिया होती है. अब जो लघु फिल्म हम आपको दिखाने जा रहे हैं वो इसी समाकलन को दर्शाता है. प्रक्षेपण की यह मुहिम कोर आधारित श्राउड के संचालन के साथ ही प्रारंभ हो जाती है, इसलिए आपको ये विस्तृत जानकारी इस लघु फिल्म में हम आपको दिखाने जा रहे हैं.
So we'll bring to you a few glimpses of GSLV F08 launch campaign activities involving integration of various stage elements and satellite. So what you see on your screen is the first segment of the S-139 stage, which is the first stage of GSLV being placed on the launch pedestal. The S-139 solid stage consists of 5 segments, and when all the 5 segments get assembled, the total propellant loading of the stage becomes 139 tons. So what you see on your screen is the assembly of all the segments. And once the S-139 stage is assembled, the middle stage, 1/2M stage, is kept on top of that to prepare for assembly of the second stage. This is the liquid strap-on motor. There are 4 liquid strap-on motors for GSLV. So first liquid strap on motor being moved to the launch pad for assembling to the S-139 stage.
जी हाँ दोस्तों, ये स्ट्रैप ऑन्स जिसे L40H विकास दो इंजन का नाम दिया गया है, इसका प्रणोद कुल 680 किलो न्यूटन होता है और इसका विशिष्ट संवेग 262 सेकंड का है। इसमें अनसिमेट्रिकल डाइमिथाइल हाइड्रोजन UDMH और UH25 का मिश्रण रहता है। ये आप देख पा रहे हैं कि दोनों तरफ दो स्ट्रैपॉन्स जोड़ दिए गए हैं, शेष दो स्ट्रैपॉन्स भी प्रथम जिसमें सॉलिड चरण था उसके साथ जोड़ दिया जाता है। और ये द्वितीय जो स्टेज है, द्वितीय चरण, इसमें विकास चार इंजन जिसका प्रणोद 800 किलो न्यूटन होता है, इसको एक प्रथम चरण के साथ जोड़ने के लिए, युग्मित करने के लिए अब लॉन्च प्रक्षेपण स्थल पर ले जा रहा है। या आप धीरे धीरे द्वितीय चरण को प्रथम चरण के साथ जोड़ने के लिए नीचे पहुंचाया जा रहा है। बड़ी सावधानी पूर्वक यह असेंबली की जाती है। इसके बाद तृतीय चरण में आप देख पा रहे हैं क्रायोजेनिक अपर स्टेज कस CE7.5, जिसके इसमें स्टेज कंबशन ऑपरेटिंग साइकिल पर आधारित होता है। इसे तृतीय चरण के रूप में, अंतिम चरण के रूप में रॉकेट के साथ जोड़ दिया जाता है। और इसके बाद ऊपर का भाग जिसे पेलोड फेयरिंग या सुरक्षा कवच भी नाम दिया जाता है, ये GSAT-6 से उसमें पेलोड एडाप्टर के साथ जोड़ने के बाद सारे परीक्षण कर लिए जाते हैं। उसके बाद दोनों जो सुरक्षा कवच हैं उसे एक साथ लगा के जोड़ दिया जाता है और यही सबसे अंतिम भाग, सबसे ऊपरी भाग यान का होता है, जिसे सबसे अंतिम चरण, अंतिम भाग के रूप में यान के साथ जोड़ा जाता है। ये आप देख पा रहे हैं अपने स्क्रीन पर किस तरह से उपग्रह को पेलोड फेयरिंग के साथ जोड़ के अब तृतीय चरण के ऊपर रखने की तैयारी।
So what you just saw is the GSAT-6A assembled, encapsulated into the payload fairing of GSLV, and the encapsulated assembly of GSAT-6A is being lifted up for placing it on top of the cryogenic stage. What you're seeing is the equipment bay deck, which houses all the onboard avionics and navigation systems, and the assembly of GSAT-6A to the GSLV-08 launcher. Once the integration of this encapsulated assembly gets completed, the platforms get folded in the vehicle assembly building, and the entire vehicle up to the spacecraft pre-assembled condition now is being prepared for movement to the umbilical tower. So the total distance it travels from this vehicle assembly building to the umbilical tower is roughly around 1 to 1.5 kilometers. And slowly, once it reaches the umbilical mast, the entire vehicle will be anchored, and it will be prepared for the final operations during the countdown phase of electrical checks and propellant filling operations. So we are back to the mission control center for the live event. The countdown is at minus 17 minutes. In the next 15 seconds, we will have an important announcement of mission director giving authorization to the vehicle director to proceed with further launch operations. So what you see on your screen is Mr. Mohan, who is the project director of this mission.
This is mission director. The readiness of GSLV F08 vehicle, GSAT-6A spacecraft, the range systems and the TTC systems are confirmed.
Clearance is available from
lab and MRR.
GSLV से.
Accordingly,
और उसी तरीके से जो उपग्रह है उसके निदेशक वी रामनाथन जी हैं, इन लोगों की मेहनत अपनी जगह है।
सो एट T-17 मिनट्स वी आर जस्ट हियरिंग द मिशन डायरेक्टर ऑथराइजिंग द व्हीकल डायरेक्टर टू प्रोसीड विद फर्दर लॉन्च ऑपरेशंस, एंड द ऑथराइजेशन इज गिवन बेस्ड ऑन द रेडीनेस ऑफ वेरियस सिस्टम्स ऑफ द व्हीकल, सैटेलाइट रेंज, टेलीमेट्री ट्रैकिंग एंड कमांड नेटवर्क। And once this authorization is given, the vehicle is now ready for takeoff at the opening of the launch window, which is, as I mentioned, 56 hours, another 16 minutes to go for the launch. So barring any unforeseen event, we expect the launch to take place at the beginning of the launch window. And the next important event is at T-16 minutes. The vehicle director has given authorization to start the automatic launch sequence. This is one of the very important event. We'll present to you a pre-recorded video documentary on the highlights of the GSLV-08 mission.
India's geosynchronous satellite launch vehicle, GSLV F08, is now standing tall majestically on the second launch pad at ISRO's Satish Dhawan Space Center in Sriharikota, with its passenger satellite safely ensconced in its payload fairing. Geosynchronous launch vehicle of ISRO, a three-stage launch vehicle system, is designed to launch 2-ton class satellites into geosynchronous transfer orbit. The first stage of the launch vehicle consists of a solid core with four liquid strap-on motors. The second stage is a liquid stage, and the upper stage uses cryogenic propulsion. The cryogenic upper stage of GSLV carries cryogenic propellants, namely liquid hydrogen and liquid oxygen, in two separate tanks. The liquid oxygen, LOX in short, is the oxidizer and is stored at minus 183 degrees Celsius. While liquid hydrogen, LH2 in short, is stored at minus 253 degrees Celsius. GSLV F08 is the 12th flight of GSLV and its 6th flight with indigenous cryogenic upper stage. With respect to its 3.4 meter diameter metallic payload fairing, GSLV F08 is similar to the previous GSLV flights. However, this flight incorporates some major improvements. The induction of high thrust Vikas engine, HTVE, in the second stage will enhance its performance. Induction of electromechanical actuation system in place of electrohydraulic actuation system shall also lead to improved reliability. Vikram Sarabhai Space Center at Thiruvananthapuram and the Liquid Propulsion Center at Valiamala are the main contributors for the launch vehicle development. The ISRO Propulsion Complex, IPRC, at Mahendragiri has tested, assembled and integrated propulsion systems and stages of GSLV F08. All stage and engine related tests of ISRO's launch vehicles are carried out here. The ISRO Inertial Systems Unit, IISU, at Thiruvananthapuram has designed, developed and qualified the inertial sensors and systems for the launch vehicles. All solid motors are realized in SDSC Shar. Let us now take you through a series of events in a typical launch. In this mission, the GSLV will be launched from the second launch pad, which was developed to accommodate PSLVs, GSLV Mark II and Mark III. In this, the vehicle is assembled and checked on a mobile launch pedestal in the vehicle assembly VAB and later moved to the launch pad on rails. This method reduces the pad occupancy and enables the vehicle to move back to VAB for protection in the event of any cyclone warning or other threat. 83 meters tall, 40 meters long and 32 meters wide VAB is equipped with 6 sets of foldable come vertically repositionable access platforms, a clean room and 2 cranes for handling loads. A kilometer long rail track connects the VAB and launch pad. Launch pad has a 70 meter tall umbilical tower. 3 vertical repositionable and swiveling access arms provide access to the vehicle. Mobile launch pedestal, MLP, over which the integrated is a 16-wheeled bogey with 4 jacks that would lift the launch pedestal and tow it to the tower on the rail tracks. During integration of the vehicle, the engineering teams can never afford to relax their guard, even for a moment. As the launch date approaches, one senses a palpable heightening of alertness and keenness in the air. As the rocket stages stack upwards, the excitement builds up almost in direct proportion. The vehicle's first stage, also known as a core stage, is 21.25 meter long and uses approximately 138 tons of composite solid propellant. 4 strap-on earth storable liquid boosters are attached to the core stage to augment it and generate the required lift-off thrust. Each booster is 19.74 meters long and carries 42.7 tons of liquid propellant. The second stage is around 11.6 meter long. It uses Earth's storable liquid propellants and weighs approximately 39.5 tons. The third stage is around 8.5 meter long. It uses cryogenic propellant, weighing approximately 12.8 tons. When the stages begin their journey towards the assembly building, the moment means a lot to the development team. The flag-off is always marked by a spontaneous cheer and a round of backslapping. These stages then get assembled in the vehicle assembly building with other stages. The moment has arrived for the fully integrated GSLV F08 vehicle on the mobile launch pedestal to move away from the vehicle assembly building towards the umbilical tower. Following the final remote checkout and fueling operation tower, the vehicle lifts off. Recently, GSLV has successfully launched satellites like GSAT-14, GSAT-6, INSAT-3DR, and the South Asia satellite. These are being used for supporting various applications in the field of communication and meteorology. In this mission, the GSLV will launch GSAT-6A communication satellite. This satellite will complement the services being provided by GSAT-6, which is already in the orbit. It will be a technology demonstrator for high-power S-band transmission from the satellite for supporting two-way communication.
फिर से हमसे जुड़ने के लिए बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद आप अपने स्क्रीन पे देख पा रहे हैं इसरो के वर्तमान जो चेयरमैन सेक्रेटरी डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ स्पेस डॉक्टर के शिवन को उनके दाएं हाथ की तरफ श्री सोमनाथ जी बैठे हुए हैं जो वीएसएससी के डायरेक्टर फिर एलपीएससी के डायरेक्टर नारायणन जी और बाईं तरफ आप देख पा रहे हैं श्री कुटनी कृष्णन जी को जो श्रीहरिकोटा के शार के डायरेक्टर हैं और उसके बाद नारायण जी की उस तरफ आप इसरो के इसरो सैटेलाइट सेंटर के डायरेक्टर श्री एम अनदरोई को देख पा रहे हैं इस समूची दर्शक दीर्घा में आप वैज्ञानिकों का एक बड़ा हुजूम देख पाते हैं जो बहुत जिनकी सफलता ने जिनकी मेहनत ने आज इसरो को इस ऊंचाई तक पहुंचाया है हम इस समय लगभग 6 मिनट 30 सेकेंड की दूरी पे हैं अभियान नियंत्रण केंद्र तथा प्रक्षेपण नियंत्रण केंद्र में सभी विशेषज्ञ उड़ान संबंधित विभिन्न प्राचलों का बड़ी सूक्ष्मता से निरीक्षण करने में व्यस्त हैं। एक दिन पूर्व उल्टी गिनती के प्रारंभ से लेकर अब तक जाने कितनी ऐसी गतिविधियां कितनी ऐसे क्रियाकलाप अति सावधानी पूर्वक संपन्न कर लिए गए हैं जिनकी सफलता ने हमारे वैज्ञानिकों के अथक प्रयासों में एक नया उत्साह भर दिया है दोस्तों जीएसएलवी D1 लॉन्च आज से करीब करीब 18 साल पहले इसी तरीके से अप्रैल 18, 2001 को सफलतापूर्वक लॉन्च किया गया था और आज हम 12वीं उड़ान जीएसएलवी F09 को लेके आपके सामने हैं।
The countdown is at minus 5 minutes 44 seconds. As I mentioned, at minus 16 minutes, the vehicle director once he authorized the start of automatic launch sequence, and the vehicle is presently going through the final phase of automatic launch sequence. Once the sequence gets initiated, from this event onwards, the vehicle level operations are taken care of by the onboard computer system, including all decision making and issue of commands. So at minus 5 minutes 20 seconds, at minus 8 minutes we had at minus 5 minutes 38 seconds we had the onboard system flight loading. At T minus 30 minutes we had the the steering program loaded into the system, and some of the important events that will, as we go through the countdown now in the next 5 minutes, will be related to mostly the checkout of the cryogenic stages as we are preparing for the launch in the final phase of activities. Now, if you have a close look at the weather conditions that prevailed at the launch base, so at the time of launch, one of the very important and critical parameters is the meteorological environment. And as far as from the ground wind and from the in-flight wind conditions, the conditions have been very benign, and which ensures that the vehicle will have a safe liftoff from the launch pad. Now, the ground winds have been very benign, as I mentioned. The upper atmospheric winds, which were measured 1 hour 40 minutes before the launch using the balloons, has been used to design the steering program. And this will eventually ensure that as the vehicle goes through the atmospheric phase of flight, it encounters very minimal loads as the winds have been used for biasing the steering programs. So we had three GPS balloon soundings that were released in a staggered mode to measure the wind speeds, and detailed simulations have been carried out towards this few hours ago. That shows the aerodynamic load and the control requirements are well within the limits. Now the countdown is at minus 3 minutes, 43 seconds. And if you look at the liftoff sequence for GSLV, as you are aware, we have four liquid strap-ons. So as the liquid strap-ons take some time for it to build the thrust, they get ignited a little earlier before we ignite the S-139 stage. So as per the nominal sequence, we will have ignition of liquid strap-ons at T-minus 4.8 seconds. And once the performance of all the liquid strap-ons are checked out in terms of its nominal performance, the command for ignition of S-139 stage, which is the core stage, is given. And only when the S-139 ignites, we have the required thrust for lifting the vehicle from the launch pad.
Minus three minutes.
The liftoff sequence is quite complex in terms of the several levels of protections it provides to ensure that once the vehicle lifts from the launch pad, it is in all conditions ready for launch with its performance normal as checked out in the ground and prepared for the launch.
धन्यवाद राधाकृष्ण जी. इस समय हम लॉन्च से करीब करीब 2 मिनट 40 सेकंड की दूरी पर. आज प्रक्षेपण स्थल पर आसमान बिल्कुल साफ, समुद्र किनारे बसे इस छोटे से कस्बे श्रीहरिकोटा में आर्द्रता का प्रभाव बेचैन कर देने वाला है. सूरज भी दिन भर की तपिश पृथ्वी पर छोड़कर धीरे धीरे अस्त होने को. हमने प्रक्षेपण मुहिम के साथ ही लगातार मौसम और हवा की गति पर नजर रखी है, जो आज जमीन पर हवा की गति खासी सामान्य है, जैसा कि आपने अपनी स्क्रीन पर देखा होगा. वायुमंडल में पृथ्वी से कुछ ऊंचाई पर आज सुबह मापी गई वायु गति द्वारा कार्यक्रम को आवश्यकता अनुसार पुनः विकल्पित कर लिया जाता है, ताकि आरोहण के दौरान वायु गति की घर्षण भार को अल्पतम किया जा सके. आज प्रातः किए गए विस्तृत अनुकरणों से ये मान सारी अपेक्षाएं जो है वो नियत सीमाओं के अंदर हैं, और सुबह के अवलोकनों के आधार पर वायुमंडलीय विद्युत क्षेत्र भी स्वीकार्य स्तर पर है. इस तरह से इस यान के प्रमोचन में हमें किसी तरह की कोई परेशानी नजर नहीं आ रही है. जो स्वचालित अनुक्रम है, ऑटोमेटिक लॉन्च सीक्वेंस, वो भी लगातार अपनी गतिविधियां जारी किए हुए निर्बाध रूप से, और हम इस समय लगभग 1 मिनट 20 सेकंड की दूरी पर लॉन्च से.
So minus 1 minute 20 seconds for the launch. At 3 minutes 30 seconds, the onboard computer has gone into the flight mode, and at 1 minute we will have the spacecraft and equipment bay nitrogen cooling system put off at 1 minute. And once this is in the view of the mission control center with the various display panels on your left, you can see the automatic launch sequence.
Minus 55 seconds.
As the onboard system is checking out the health parameters of the launch vehicle and the spacecraft.
All sequences. Minus 45 seconds.
Minus 45 seconds.
Minus 40 seconds.
So we'll have
minus 35 seconds.
We'll have the ignition of L40 at minus 4.8 seconds.
Stage is ready. Minus 30 seconds.
RS real-time programs activated.
Minus 25 seconds.
All our movies are opened.
Minus 20 seconds. Minus 15 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, five, four, three, two, one, zero, plus one, plus two, plus three, plus four.
L40 ignition nominal, S139 ignited, and vehicle lifts off from the launch pad.
बिल्कुल सामान प्रज्वलन और व्हीकल का प्रक्षेपण.
R3 tracking.
So vehicle lift off normal and performance of L40s and S139 has been indicated as normal.
First stage performance normal.
पूरी गर्जना के साथ जमीन के हरित और विशाल का संकेत को अलविदा कहता हुआ GSLVF-08 अपनी उस यात्रा पर निकल पड़ा है जहां से उसे गंतव्य के अंतिम चरण पर भारतीय संचार उपग्रह GSLV-6A को अंतरिक्ष में प्रक्षेपित करना है. आप अपने स्क्रीन पर बाकायदा इसके गंतव्य पथ को देख पा रहे हैं.
So 52 seconds into the flight, the vehicle has crossed the atmospheric phase, which is a very critical phase. Right now it is
plus 1 minute.
11 kilometers. And as per the flight sequence, we will have the burnout of S139 stage at 110 seconds when the vehicle would have reached an altitude of around 42.
Sharp 1 in main auto.
So at 75 seconds, performance
sharp 2 in main auto.
Very normal in terms of time versus altitude
first
and time versus velocity.
Normal.
So after the S139 burnout, we will have the liquid strap-ons burning for the next 40 seconds. And after the L40 burns out, together the four liquid strap-ons and S139 will get separated at 151 seconds. So we are at 100 seconds exactly, altitude around 35 kilometers, and a velocity of 1.5 kilometers.
S139 burnout normal.
So we just heard the announcement. S139 has burnt out at 109 seconds.
प्लस 2 मिनट.
जी हाँ, जो कोर स्टेज थी S139 वो प्रक्षेपण से बर्न आउट हो चुकी है. इस समय एक स्क्रीन के आप जो देख पा रहे होंगे वो बाकायदा GSLV को अंतिम बिंदु की तरह आगे बढ़ते हुए. इस समय हम कुछ ही क्षणों में 150 सेकंड के आसपास द्वितीय चरण के इग्निशन का और प्रथम चरण के पृथक्करण का क्षण देख सकेंगे.
So the event,
L40's engine shut off.
Yes, L40 engine has been
second
shut off.
Second stage ignited.
At 149 seconds, the second stage has been ignited. And the first stage separation successfully completed 152 seconds.
बड़ी ही महत्वपूर्ण घड़ियां होती हैं जब ये द्वितीय चरण इग्नाइट होता है या प्रज्वलित होता है, प्रथम चरण अलग होता है. इसी के साथ ही जो इंटर स्टेज था वो भी अलग हो चुका है.
Second stage performance normal.
और द्वितीय चरण का जो निष्पादन है वो पूरी तरह से सामान्य.
So we just heard the second stage performance is normal. The flight time is 185 seconds and the vehicle has reached an altitude of around 97 kilometers. The next very important event that we await is at 225 seconds, which is around 30 seconds from now, when the vehicle would have reached an altitude of 115 kilometers, when the heat shield or the payload fairing separation would happen. Right now, heat shield is protecting the spacecraft from the dense atmospheric phase. It has crossed from liftoff to the space. So 215 seconds, another 10 seconds to go before we have the view of the payload fairing separation.
जी हाँ, उसमें सुरक्षा कवच के अलग
अलग. Payload fairing separated.
Payload fairing successfully separated at 226 seconds.
सफलतापूर्वक पेलोड फेयरिंग उसमें सुरक्षा अलग हो गई और इस समय उपग्रह जो है वातावरण से पूरी तरह से आमने सामने. आप अपने टीवी स्क्रीन पर जो ग्राफ देख पा रहे हैं उसमें क्षैतिज अक्ष एक्स पर समय तथा ऊर्ध्वाधर अक्ष वाई पर ऊंचाई और वेग को प्रदर्शित किया गया है. यान के अनुमानित पथ को पहले अंकित कर उसकी तुलना अभिलिखित पथ से की जाती है. इसी तुलना को आप चमकते हुए बिंदु के रूप में देख पा रहे हैं जो हूबहु अनुमानित पथ को अनुकरणित करते हुए अपने निर्दिष्ट पथ पर अग्रसर है. इस समय हम करीब करीब 4.4 किलोमीटर प्रति सेकंड की का वेग प्राप्त कर चुके हैं और इस समय 270 सेकंड समय व्यतीत कर चुके हैं.
सो राइट नाउ वी आर एट 275 सेकंड्स, द ऑल्टीट्यूड 131 and the relative velocity of around 4.9 km per second. In the next
engine shut off.
Yes, we just heard the announcement GS2 has been shut off
and
it has been separated. It has been separated.
Yeah,
yes.
That's the good news. GS2 Duti Charan jo hai wo alag ho chuka hai. Aur agla jo hai.
Just 5 minutes.
First stage ignition confirmed.
And cryogenic ignition stage has been ignited and it has been confirmed. And the event has happened at 298.7 seconds. And the cryogenic ignition has been confirmed. The stage in the cryogenic stage is going to burn for the next 700 plus seconds before it imparts the orbital velocity to the satellite to the extent of around 10.2 kilometers per second, which is the inertial velocity. And this event,
stage performance normal.
This event should happen up to at 1066 seconds. Right now we are at 336 seconds into the flight. The altitude around 138 kilometers. And if you look at the downrange, the vehicle has crossed from the time it has lifted out from the launch base, it is nearly 900 kilometers from Shar now. And the vehicle has achieved a relative velocity of 5.13. Now, if you look at the total velocity breakup, the first, second, and the upper stage gives to the satellite before it goes into the geosynchronous transfer orbit. The cryogenic stage imparts almost 50% of the velocity to enable it to reach the final destined orbit of 170 km perigee and 36,000 km apogee. And right now we are at 380 seconds. The velocity is almost 5.2 and the vehicle is at an altitude of 140. Now if you look at the display plots of time versus altitude and time versus velocity, which is a plot on your screen, and the plot of the pre-flight and the what is being achieved, a very, very close match to both the parameters, which are basically the governing parameters for any launch, altitude and the velocity.
Cryo stage performance normal.
And very close match with respect to pre-flight and cryo stage performance normal.
जी हाँ, इस समय जो क्रायोजेनिक स्टेज है वो बहुत ही सामान्य निष्पादन देते हुए. दर्शकों, आपने कई बार सुना होगा कि हम स्वदेशी तकनीक से विकसित क्रायोजेनिक इंजन का उपयोग करते हैं. ये चरण इसलिए इतना जटिल और तकनीक रूप से महत्वपूर्ण है क्योंकि जिन द्रव गैसों का इस्तेमाल हम ईंधन के रूप में करते हैं उनका भंडारण, उनके नियंत्रित व सुनियोजित प्रवाह के लिए प्रयुक्त विधि व यंत्र, उनमें उपयोग में लाए गए पदार्थ और उनके गुणधर्म बेहद जटिल और गहन अध्ययन और अनवरत प्रायोगिक अनुभव चाहते हैं. हाइड्रोजन को -253 और ऑक्सीजन को -193 डिग्री सेल्सियस के ताप क्रम पर संचित किया जाता है. अभी तक जो प्रश्न जो संपादन है जो निष्पादन है सॉरी वो बिल्कुल सामान्य. वर्तमान उड़ान में जो प्रयुक्त तीसरा चरण है सर्वाधिक महत्वपूर्ण है ये क्योंकि बड़ी जटिल और उच्च तकनीक पर आधारित क्रायोजेनिक इंजन है. इसका विशिष्ट आवेग द्रव इंजन जो द्वितीय चरण था उसकी तुलना में लगभग डेढ़ गुना होता है और यही वजह है कि इसके उपयोग के प्राथमिकता की. इस समय हम लगभग 484 सेकंड का समय व्यतीत कर चुके हैं. दर्शकों, आपको बता दूं कि लगभग 1066 सेकंड के बाद हमें करीब करीब 9.745 किलोमीटर प्रति सेकंड का जो वेग है उसे प्राप्त करना है. तो अभी कुछ दूर है जब तक क्रायोजेनिक स्टेज का क्रायोजेनिक चरण का जो निष्पादन है वो अगर सामान्य बना रहा, सब कुछ सामान्य रहा, तो हम निश्चित रूप से इसकी सफलता की कामना कर पाएंगे. आप अपने स्क्रीन पे समय एमसीसी के अंदर बिखरे हुए जो उत्साह है उसको देख पा रहे हैं.
So the flight time is 524 seconds, altitude 136, and velocity of nearly 5.7 km per second. So we are halfway into the flight. The total flight time, as Mr. Alok was mentioning, is
plus
around 1066 seconds. So we are roughly halfway, around at 540 seconds right now. Just to make a quick mention of the performance of the cryogenic stage, which Mr. Alok was mentioning. The cryogenic stage in this particular mission is going to impart almost 50% of the velocity to what the first and second stage imparts to this particular vehicle. The primary reason for this being the highest efficiency it provides in terms of the specific impulse compared to the solid and unstorable liquid propellants which are being used in the lower stage of the rocket now. Now, if you look at the specific impulse, which is primarily a measure of the efficiency, which is achieved by a cryo, is of the order of 450 seconds compared to 3 seconds being provided by earth storable or maybe a solid fuels. which gives a quite a substantial payload advantage as far as the overall mission is concerned. But in fact, what does it do really is when we have this kind of higher specific impulse for the upper stage, every 1 second improvement in the specific impulse adds up to something like 10 plus kilograms of the payload it can additionally carry in that particular mission, which we feel is quite a substantial advantage while we use the cryogenic stage. But as you may appreciate, every advantage will come with the associated technological complexity. As cryogenic propellants operate at extremely low temperature, it poses quite a substantial thermal and structural problems to the designers. And just to get a feel of the kind of temperatures it operates at extremely low temperatures. Just to give an update on the flight now at 640 seconds, the altitude is around 131. It's quite a shallow trajectory, as you can, you'll be seeing in your screen very shortly. What you're seeing right now is the ground trace from the time the vehicle lifted off from Shar. So on the way up to the last
plus
event.
11 minutes.
Yes, the very shallow trajectory, the altitude is 131 kilometers, but the velocity has been continuously being added to the vehicle to something like 6.3 right now. The expected velocity when the upper stage cuts off is around 9.7. So I think we feel maybe another 3 kilometer velocity has to be added by the cryogenic stage now in the next 400 seconds of flight.
जी हाँ राधाकृष्ण जी, आइए अभी तो थोड़ा समय है प्रज्वलन में, हम कुछ बातें कर ले. राधाकृष्ण जी हमारे साथ, हमारे इसरो के साथ और हमारे जो विदेशी उपभोक्ता होते हैं उनके साथ की एक बहुत महत्वपूर्ण कड़ी है. राधाकृष्ण जी, हमारे, मुझे कई बार ये सवाल मन में आता है कि पीएसएलवी लगातार हमारे साथ, हमको लगातार सफलताएं देता रहा, और अगर इस तरह की सफलता हम जीएसएलवी में प्राप्त करते रहे तो एक दिन निश्चित रूप से हमारे उपभोक्ताओं के लिए जीएसएलवी भी आप सफलतापूर्वक उनको पेश कर पाएंगे.
यू आर एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट आलोक. आई थिंक वी आर वेरी एंशियसली लुकिंग एट द सक्सेस रेट ऑफ जीएसएलवी दैट इज हैज बीन सीन इन द लास्ट सेवरल इयर्स. टुडे बीइंग द 12th फ्लाइट, we are definitely looking at whether we'll be in the future able to launch some of the international customers using GSLV as such in the mission, I think.
जी हाँ. अच्छा, दूसरी चीज रिडक्शन जो कई बार मेरे दिमाग में आती है वो ये कि देखिए, आप प्रथम चरण सेपरेट हुआ, द्वितीय चरण, सो दीज सेपरेशन इम्पैक्ट्स एक्चुअली दे आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इवेंट फॉर एनी मिशन. सो लेट्स टॉक लिटिल अबाउट द सेपरेशन सिस्टम्स अबाउट द from in the various stages.
Absolutely right. Like if you look at the kind of separations the GSLV employs in this particular manner, as you are aware, this is a three-stage vehicle. So in terms of the number of stage separation that happens when you compare with PSLV, it's very minimal here. We have only separation of first stage, which comprises of S-139 and L-40s also, and then the second stage, and the third stage goes into the orbit. So number of separations are lesser compared to PSLV. Yes, it's quite a challenging event to happen when the launch vehicle is going through the entire flight regime. Now, just to come back to the mission control center, the time right now is around 800 seconds, and we are into the next 200 seconds of remaining flight. But as far as the velocity builder, there is a plot on your screen. The time versus altitude, as I was mentioning, from the time the cryo stage got ignited at 130 kilometers, we are almost at the same altitude right now, 136. But in terms of velocity, almost 3 kilometer velocity has been added to the entire vehicle. So right now we are looking at another 2 kilometer velocity to be imparted, so that we reach the final designated orbit of 170 kilometers perigee and 36,000 kilometer apogee.
That's so, right. Yeah. So Radhakrishnan ji, is samay main darshakon ko thoda sa is bare mein batata chalun ki jo ek baat mahatvapurn jo promotion ke hone ya na hone se judi hoti hai, wo hai antariksh vastu nikatta vishleshan. इम्पैक्ट एनालिसिस एक्चुअली इस विश्लेषण का आधार है संघट या टकराहट का खतरा. कक्षा में पहुंचने के बाद किसी भी पूर्व विद्यमान वस्तु, जिसे हम डेब्रिज भी कह सकते हैं, से यान के अंतिम चरण या उपग्रह से टकराने की संभावना का अनुमान लगाना इस विश्लेषण का मुख्य उद्देश्य होता है. ऐसे किसी भी संभावित टकराहट से बचने के लिए प्रमोचन समय को उपलब्ध प्रमोचन विंडो में उचित रूप से समायोजित कर लिया जाता है. शार से किए गए पिछले कई प्रक्षेपणों में अंतरिक्ष वस्त्र निकटता विश्लेषण एक प्रमाणित और महत्वपूर्ण तरीका है। पिछले कुछ प्रक्षेपणों में इसी अध्ययन के आधार पर प्रमोचन यान में कुछ क्षणों की देरी भी की गई थी, मगर आज का जो प्रक्षेपण था बिल्कुल सामान्य और संभावित समय पर ही हुआ। इसी तरीके से जैसे अभी हमने राधा कृष्ण जी से सुना था कि बहुचरण आधारित यान जो होते हैं उनके विभिन्न चरणों के उनके उपयोग हो जाने के बाद मुख्य यान से अलग कर दिया जाता है, ताकि एक तो डेड मास कम हो जाए और दूसरी चीज उसको यान को ज्यादा एफिशिएंटली ज्यादा क्षमता पूर्वक तरीके से उपयोग में लाया जा सके। इस समय हम लगभग 915 सेकंड समय व्यतीत कर चुके हैं और 8.29 किलोमीटर प्रति सेकंड का वेग प्राप्त कर चुके हैं और अभी तक जो निष्पादन है वो पूरी तरह से सामान्य क्रायोजेनिक स्टेज का।
We just heard the announcement from the range operation director. The cryogenic stage performance is normal. We are into the final 100 seconds of cryogenic stage burn. Right now the time is 940 seconds. Altitude is slowly rising now, 170 kilometers, nearly an 8.5. Another 1 kilometer velocity to be imparted. And if you can see on your screen, the vehicle has almost attained the orbital velocity. And what we see on our screen is the vehicle is at 140 kilometer perigee and 5000 kilometer apogee. Maybe so in the next 100 seconds, you will have the perigee being raised by 30 kilometers, whereas the apogee will rise almost from 8000 to something like 36000 kilometer. So quite a substantial energy is going to be added in the next 70 to 80 seconds of flight while for raising the apogee of the final mission. So 985 seconds, 188 kilometer altitude, 9 kilometer velocity, and the orbit is at 144 by 12600.
जी हाँ, करीब करीब 995 सेकंड। इस समय हम चाहते ये हैं कि 170 किलोमीटर की पेरिजी मिल जाए और उपभू और जो नॉमिनल है वो करीब 36,060 किलोमीटर का अपोजी पॉइंट मिल जाए और इस समय हम कुछ ही क्षणों में लगभग 60 सेकंड की दूरी पर। हमें ऐसा अनुमानित है कि जो वांछित हमारी अभीष्ट अभीष्ट आंकड़े हैं, जो पैरामीटर्स हैं, वो हमें प्राप्त हो जाएंगे। हम लोग बहुत ही गहन अध्ययन करते हुए आंकड़ों का, इस समय सारे वैज्ञानिक लगातार निगाह बनाए हुए, क्योंकि बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण घड़ी आपके बिल्कुल सामने आने वाली है जब क्रायोजेनिक इंजन को शट ऑफ कर दिया जाएगा, बंद कर दिया जाएगा। हम बहुत ही करीब 1036 सेकंड बीत चुके हैं, 1051.88 सेकंड पे इंजन बंद होगा और 1066.88 सेकंड पे सैटेलाइट को अलग कर दिया जाएगा।
सो 1047 सेकंड्स, yes,
engine shut off.
Engine, cryogenic engine has been shut off.
Injection conditions achieved.
And we have reached the very precise designated orbit of 170 kilometer and 36,000 kilometer. Apogee, orbit inclination of 20.6 kilometer. And the confirmation GSAT-6A has been successfully separated from the launch vehicle. In a very precise, the mission has been extremely precise, where it could reach its perigee and apogee conditions and inclination conditions.
जी हाँ, GSAT-6 को अलग किया जा चुका सफलतापूर्वक। इसरो को और समस्त उपभोक्ताओं को बहुत बहुत बधाई हो। इस सारे प्रसारण तक आप हमारे साथ बने रहे, इसके लिए तहे दिल से हम आपके शुक्रगुजार हैं, आभारी हैं। इस समय हम अभियान नियंत्रण केंद्र MCC के अंदर बिखरे उत्साह और इसरो भारत के एक नई उपलब्धियों में शामिल होने के लिए सीधे आपको वहीं लिए चलते हैं। आप स्क्रीन पर देख पा रहे हो डॉक्टर के शिवन, इसरो के चेयरमैन की जो प्रसन्नता है बिल्कुल चेहरे पर परिलक्षित होते हुए। उन्होंने मोहन जी को गले से लगा लिया है और इस समय उन्हें बधाई देते हुए।
Yes, GSAT-6A, ISRO student class communication satellite has been successfully injected and today's launch is a landmark achievement for the country, demonstrating further that India is self-reliant in developing the most technologically complex cryogenic stage and launching Tuton class communication satellite. With this wonderful feeling of success and proud moments for the entire ISRO community, myself Radhakrishnan and my colleague Alok, we are signing off from the Mission Control Center and we take you to the center stage of the Mission Control Center where Dr. K. Shivan, Chairman ISRO, will be shortly addressing the ISRO community.
बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।
Thank you.
नमस्कार, जय हिंद। मैं और राधाकृष्ण जी आप सभी को विदा चाहते हैं। धन्यवाद।
My dear friends, good evening to all of you. Today, the fifth successful launch of GSLV with indigenous cryogenic stage successfully placed the high power S band communication satellite GSAT-6A in the designated orbit precisely. GSAT-6A is complement to GSAT-6, which is already in the orbit. These two satellites combinedly going to provide platform for development of advanced technologies such as unfurlable antenna, handheld devices, and ground networks for point-to-point satellite communications, which is going to provide a major facility to India. This GSLV Epsilon-8, it is not just like another vehicle. There are improvements we have incorporated on the way to enhance the performance of GSLV towards achieving something like 3 tons, 50% more capability than the present system. The first improvements we have incorporated is mainly on increasing the thrust level of the second stage, which is going to give something like a 6% enhancement in the capability of the vehicle, number one. Second one, another major change we have made is incorporation of electromechanical actuator in the second stage. But interesting fact is this actuator is being driven by indigenously developed and realized lithium-ion batteries. It is to be noted that this technology only now government is trying to push it to industries for making e-vehicles. And regarding this activity, this wonderful success we got mainly because of the untiring hard work and dedicated work of the entire team ISRO as well as their family members. Let me compliment their work as well as congratulate them for giving this wonderful gift to India. At the same time, the people really work behind is the review system we have, excellent review systems like the flight readiness review as well as mission readiness review. They have gone through the data, bits and pieces. That way only we got the successful mission. Also, the industry of India really contributed for this the wonderful mission. Let me also congratulate and compliment the industries as well as review team members for getting this the great success. Now, what is next? Definitely, ISRO is having a very huge plan. This year is going to be another high-profile year for ISRO. In next 9 months, we are going to have 10 missions of dispersed, diversified applications like space science, earth observations, communications, navigation. All the areas we are going to have missions in this year. We are going to have, there is the high accurate, high resolution satellites for remote sensing. We are going to have high bandwidth satellite for communication purpose. This is going to make a revolution in India. Along with that, we are going to have that major mission in this year, this on Chandrayaan 2. At the same time, next mission is going to be not far away. We are going to have the mission in another 2 weeks for having that IRNSS-1I mission. And definitely, this ISRO is giving a lot of work for the team members. And I'm sure that with the effort, whatever you're putting, we can rise to the occasion. And why 10? We can even have more and more missions very soon. And on this occasion, let me once again congratulate and compliment the entire team ISRO and their family members for the wonderful achievement. And now let me ask Mr. Kunyikrishnan, he is the director of the spaceport, tell a few words.
At the outset, let me congratulate the whole ISRO team from various centers for achieving this magnificent mission in such a precise manner, injecting the GSAT-6A into a very precise orbit. That clearly demonstrates the capability and maturity of GSLV as an operational launcher. It's a matter of coincidence that the first mission of our chairman, Dr. K. Shivan, happened to be a very important mission with GSLV, his own vehicle. And all of us know that he was the project director of the first successful GSLV mission with the Indian cryostage. But now today, GSLV has transformed into a very reliable workhorse of ISRO, even capable of taking up interplanetary missions like Chandrayaan 2, planning to launch in this year. So today the activity at Sriharikota, if you see, there are three launch campaigns going on parallelly. In addition to GSLV F0, the current mission, the PSLV C41 that will carry the navigation satellite IRNSS-1I has been fully integrated at the first launch pad, and the GSLV Mark 3 D2 activities also have been commenced at the SSAB complex at Achar. And for the first time, we will be having the launch, the next launch, PSLV C41, in a very short span of, even within 2 weeks, that this we are going to attempt for the first time. And I am sure that the launch will take place in the first half of March. And let me, at this point of time, let me wish all the very best to our GSAT 6A team, the spacecraft team, for the post-launch on-orbit operations. I'm sure that is going to be a successful one. And I'm sure GSAT 6A will provide excellent service to our country in the coming years. So before I conclude, let me congratulate once again the entire ISRO team, and let's all work together to see that whatever ambition our chairman has expressed here will fulfill satisfactorily. That will give laurel to our country. Thank you.
Let me ask Mr. Somnath, is the head of that launch vehicle, to say a few words.
Dear friends, the naughty boy tamed by Dr. Shivan is behaving very well under his leadership. Today in this mission, F08, GSLV F08, GSAT 6A mission, perfect orbit has been achieved. And the satellite is put in a very good orbit, which will assure its long life and service to the nation. As already mentioned, the improvements that has been brought in the GSLV, all of them have performed very well. One of the important thing was that we were planning to take the maximum out of the cryogenic stage by burning to depletion. And that also has ensured that the orbit that has been put is also an excellent orbit, which is almost close to nominal. The spacecraft, after this successful deployment, will go through its operations to make it functional. And I am sure the remaining operations on the satellite also will go through very well, which will ensure a wonderful service that will be given by the spacecraft to this country. At this outset, I want to congratulate everybody who is involved in the realization of this launch vehicle and the satellite spread across all the ISRO centers for their tireless work, dedication, and making this launch vehicle succeed every time that we are attempting. And all of us realize that launch vehicle business and space business is a very risky activity, and all your care and attention, personal attention, and your commitment is what is making this launch vehicle mission succeed again and again. Wish once again for great success for all of us in the missions that have been scheduled immediately and the years to come. Thank you so much.
Let me ask Mr. Mohan, who was the mission director for this particular unique mission, He was my lieutenant when I was heading this project. I request him to use a few words.
Good evening to all. Let me wish first hearty congratulations to all for the grand success of the GSLV F08 GSAT-6A mission. The GSLV F08 mission successfully accomplished today is a very significant milestone in the GSLV program. We have injected many new technologies as informed, which will lead to an enhancement of the payload to more than 2.5 tons in the near future. The thrust upgradement of the second stage and the full utilization of the cryo stage propellant are two significant technologies demonstrated today. The success is also a welcome gift to our beloved Chairman ISRO, Dr. Shivan, who was instrumental in turning around the fortunes of GSLV through the GSLV D5 mission in 2014 and gave belief and confidence to the project at a very difficult time. I wish to thank Chairman ISRO for the constant encouragement and motivation to the project team, and which will continue to perform to make us better, sir. Thank you very much, sir. I thank all the center directors for this continuous guidance to this project at every stage of this mission, especially when we had a very difficult time in the engine realization, and gave management directives and alternate solutions which made this cryo stage realization itself possible. Also, teamwork makes dreams work. That is what is told. In that context, I congratulate all the system teams and SR teams from the launch vehicle centers, VSSC, LPSC, IPRC, SDSC, IISU for this marvelous achievement and for accepting the tough targets and challenges with an open heart and achieving them with innovative planning. The realization of the stages and the subassemblies in a flawless manner in the shortest time, giving consistent and reliable performance, shows immense confidence of the operational teams and the maturity of the GSLV vehicle as a whole. I also thank the chairman and members of the MRR and the FRR committees who helped us tide over many crisis situations and guided us towards the goal of achieving a very successful mission. I congratulate and thank my GSLV project core team for this fantastic success achieved today, especially the vehicle director, Mr. Giri, and the associate vehicle director, Mr. Gopalakrishnan Nair, who stood like rocks with me in planning and executing the vehicle systems realization within a targeted schedule and made this possible mission today. This success will be a great boost to our project team in taking up many challenges ahead. I also thank the various industry partners who have delivered the many hardware components and integrated systems, meeting our stringent quality requirements and schedule. I compliment the GSAT-6A spacecraft team and wish them good luck for the mission operations. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.
I request Dr. Annadurai, Director, Satellite Center, to say a few words.
Good evening to all. I think it's a very, very fine welcoming gift to our chairman. A combination of GSLV doing extremely well with the combination of giving the GSAT-6A a technically well-deserved satellite also going combination. And while this happening, you look at here already in the spaceport, we are looking for the next PSLV launch with IRNSS. That means satellite team also providing all the launch vehicles. Presently, we have the IRNSS 1I is method and getting ready for the launch. And this mission, GSAT-6A, now it is in the orbit, joining 24 more other satellites. That means from today, the panels deployed and it is inching towards for the final configuration. The days to come, we have three consecutive maneuvers followed by the 6-meter unfurlable antenna to be deployed. Then it will acquire the station a week from now. A week from then, we will have come back here again for IRNSS 1A launch. Then parallelly, we have another ambitious GSAT-11 positioned for the another launch vehicle, which will make a communication point of view the satellite which will graduating much better way to give the digital India point of view giving that. Parallelly, another satellite GSAT-29 is getting ready for the Mach 3. That means this year many things are happening indicating what's going to come there. So this whole of ISRO family working hard to make these things to happen. That means beyond our capacities to bring in, we are roping in industries, in much bigger way. Probably it will happen in the coming weeks. Already IRNS-1I has been fully assembled by the industry. He is now in the spaceport. Now we are thinking probably some more satellites. Also, AIT will be done by the industry. That means Indian industry and ISRO together, in the space era point of view, we have a long more to jump. Requirements to field the concern, we'll be able to do that. That means more reliable launch vehicle, more reliable satellites, providing the service to the Indian community. I think things is going very, very better way. This is one of such occasion wherein we have the long holidays in this week. But you can see the intensity in which ISRO is working for the various satellites, and it shows the way in which ISRO and the ISRO community and the industries are rising to the occasion. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Now this launch vehicle has given the satellite to put the orbit. Now the satellite's responsibility. I request the satellite director to give some few words.
Good evening to all. Let me compliment the entire GSLV team and the mission director for the successful injection of GSAT-6A in the desired orbit. This satellite will further augment the services to the user. The satellite system parameters are normal and the power generation is as expected after the solar array deployment. In the coming days, mission expert at the Master Control Facility Hassan will carry out the further orbitizing operations, and subsequently the antenna deployment, which is very unique to this particular satellite. I take this opportunity to thank Chairman ISRO, Dr. Sivan, Director Isaac, Center Directors, Seniors, and the project executives at ISAC and other centers for their continuous support in realizing this particular mission. Thank you, one and all.
This cryogenic stage always used to make a fire in our belly, but it never let us down. Our director, LPSC, will give about say, a few words about that, the propulsion systems used in this vehicle.
Thank you, sir. Today, we had the successful launch of 12th GSLV, equipped with the 6th Indian cryogenic upper stage, under the leadership of our beloved chairman, Dr. K. Sivan. As you all know, this complex and high-performance cryogenic propulsion system was a technology which was denied to India, and today we can be proud that already we have mastered and it is repeatedly working very well. This successful launch is due to the dedicated, sincere, and systematic hard work of Team ISRO and the meticulous review process and contributions from Indian industries. On this occasion, on behalf of Liquid Propulsion System Center, I congratulate, compliment, and salute the entire Team ISRO and their family members and the contributing industrial partners. Specifically, I wish to contribute the two project directors, Mr. Mohan, Project Director GSLV, and Mr. Jain, Project Director CUSP, who has meticulously done their job. In this vehicle, as it was told, we have demonstrated two important aspects of the propulsion system. The second stage Vikas engine, the thrust level is enhanced from 80 ton to 85 ton, almost 6% we have enhanced, and we have demonstrated for the first time. And we have also demonstrated the last depletion mode shutdown of the cryogenic upper stage. These two improvements will contribute for achieving the intended 2,500 kg, which was originally planned in GTO, capability of this vehicle in the future missions. ISRO management has set great targets for LPSC for delivering the liquid propulsion systems for launch vehicle and spacecrafts for the forthcoming mission. Sir, on behalf of the dedicated LPSC team, I assure Chairman ISRO, we will give all support and we will meet all the challenging targets what you have set for the center. Once again, on this occasion, let me congratulate and compliment entire Team ISRO and the sacrificing family members for this magnificent and marvelous and wonderful achievement. Thank you very much.
Cryogenics stages being made at IPRC as well as the liquid stages. I request Director IPRC to tell a few words.
Respected Chairman ISRO, dear colleagues, good evening to all of you. Today this GSLF08 GSAT-6A success is added another feather to the ISRO cap. At this juncture, let me compliment and congratulate each and every one of you who has contributed tirelessly to this wonderful mission. This GSLF08 has achieved two goals in one stroke. One is first putting the GSAT-6A at the designated slot. Second is whatever essential elements required to have confidence on Chandrayaan-2, those elements have been proved, like high-thrust Vikas engine, electromechanical actuator, lithium-ion battery, etc. This high-thrust Vikas engine underwent 11 tests successfully, meeting all the requirements. The cryogenic stage acceptance tests underwent completely, met all the requirements. In fact, these 4 L40 and the GS2 stage, CUS stage, were delivered on record time without no non-conformances. This shows the maturity of the entire team ISRO. And at this juncture, let me congratulate once again and thank Team IPRC, Team ISRO, and our industrial partners. In fact, our GSAT-6A is going to give us a boost to the mobile connectivity in the days to come. At this juncture, let me once again congratulate and compliment, and also our dedicated scientists and engineers are ready to face the challenges being demanded by the country to meet the common man need. Thank you once again.
The success of the mission, the precision of the mission is depends on the inertial system. And I request the Director IASC to give some few words.
Respected Chairman, Center Directors, dear colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, I am happy to share with you my excitement on the successful launch of GSAT-6A in GSLV F08 mission. Let me congratulate the mission director on his maiden success and the project team and the team ISRO spread across the country in different centers and units, as well as the Indian industry who have played a major role in realizing this vehicle for this wonderful mission we have accomplished. This is the culmination of excellent mission planning and teamwork and has made the difference in this mission when we had faced certain hiccups at the beginning of the schedule. GSAT-6A has been injected into a precise and beneficial orbit thanks to the performance of navigation system as well as the propulsion modules. The spacecraft has been injected elegantly, and the initial rates sensed by the spacecraft gyros are very benign. I understand that the spacecraft systems are performing excellently well. I sincerely thank all of you and your families, and in particular my colleagues in IASU, for this excellent contribution in delivering quality products for the launch vehicle as well as the spacecraft and achieving the performance what we have seen today. Let me wish spacecraft team for the successful mission operations and operationalize the spacecraft as planned in the days to come. Let us gear up for more challenging missions in this year and nurture our culture, ISRO culture of enjoying more and more challenges to serve our country and bring the fruits of space technology for the common man. Congratulations and thank you once again. Jai Hind.
For the last 3 months, the person who stayed in the Sri Hari Kota and directed the team to build this vehicle give the shape to the vehicle and made it possible to launch is the vehicle director, Mr. N.P. Giri. I request him to tell some few words about and come to the conclusion.
Good evening to you all. We started the launch campaign on New Year Day of this year. Like every campaign, it had its own challenges, issues, solutions, and finally relief. This launch vehicle F08, we had three changes and challenges. In fact, our engine designers have raised the bar for our Barkhuat Figaz engine, taking it from 58 bar to 62 bar, giving us additional 60 kg payload. The electromechanical actuator, which is more robust, at the same time more complex, was introduced to the GS2 stage, which also performed very well. Then we took our cryo stage to the LOX depletion, which is a prelude to the Chandrayaan mission, which gave additional payload and maximum benefit to the satellites. This work was the result of the strenuous mental and physical work of hundreds of people and teams spread across the various centers of ISRO, led by eminent managers or directors, chairman Dahl, and advised by our professors, senior professors and gurus in the FR, LV and MRR, who gave valuable advices which made this mission successful. At this juncture, I compliment and congratulate all the team members who have put their effort to make the mission grand success. Thank you.
My dear friends, yes, our former chairman used to tell that the best gift for good work is to give more work. And I am strictly following his footsteps. And a lot of work is in front of you. And definitely, you will be doing that. I don't have any doubt on that. But at the same time, whatever the missions we are planning this year, all 10 missions are very, very high-profile mission, which is going to make India's position in that space by the nations in a very big way. That is Chandrayaan 2, which is going to land on a moon and roving on the moon to get more and more science about the moon in unexploded area. That is the one thing. Also, we are going to have the high power, high bandwidth, the communication satellite is going to provide the high bandwidth connectivity to the remote places of India. That is another mission. And we are going to have a couple of IRNSS mission we are going to have, and science mission, many, many missions are there. And we have one demonstration for that human in space program technology development also. So a lot of exciting activities are waiting for you. Please get ready. I'm sure that with all your help, we can achieve many things. And once again, I thank all of you for the wonderful support, and we will continue to work together. Jai Hind. Thank you.